Welcome to our tutorial on manually handling involuntary reissues. Involuntary reissue is a term commonly used in the travel and airline industry. It refers to the process of an airline changing a passenger's ticket without their request. This situation can arise for various reasons, such as flight cancellations, schedule changes, or operational requirements. Involuntary reissues help ensure that passengers can still reach their destination despite disruptions. While this process is primarily a privilege of the airlines, travel agents may also reissue tickets they have issued without additional cost, provided they receive prior approval from the airline. In our example, the originally booked return flight from Dallas to Doha via Chicago has been canceled or is no longer operational. The new route offered is from DFW, Dallas, to Doha via JFK, New York. To delete the inactive flight segments and confirm the new connection at the same time, follow these steps to update the PNR with the revised itinerary. Use the RF received from transaction command. Enter your name followed by a semicolon, then ERK. Press Enter to execute the update and save. Before initiating an involuntary reissue, contact the airline to request a waiver for any penalties and additional charges that may arise, including those related to changes in the bank's selling rate. Once you have received approval, it's advisable to check the coupon status of the issued ticket. To check the coupon status of the issued ticket, follow these steps. Use the TWD transaction. Type a slash, followed by the letter L, identify the line. Enter number 11, specify the FA element from the PNR. Press Enter. This will display the coupon status for both used and unused segments of the itinerary. To update the new itinerary segments in the last used TST record for the issued ticket, follow these steps. Display the attached TST record details by using the TQT transaction code. Type a slash followed by T1, identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Press Enter. This will show the details of the TST record, allowing you to update it with the new itinerary segments. To update the new itinerary segments in the displayed TST record, follow these steps. Use the TT2 transaction code. Type a slash followed by T1, identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Type another slash, then letter S, identify the segments. Enter the range of line numbers for the new itinerary segments. 4-6. The segments are from line number 4 to line number 6 from the PNR. Press Enter. The system responds with Update OK. It means that the required segments from lines 4 to 6 have been successfully replaced with the new itinerary segments in the originally issued ticket. To remove the change flag from the updated TST record, follow these steps. Use the TTF transaction code. Type a slash followed by T1, identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Press Enter. The system will respond with TST flag removed, confirming that the originally issued segments have been successfully replaced with the new itinerary segments. To update the TST record with the required mandatory fields, follow these steps. To update the fare base and the TST record, follow these steps. Use the TTK transaction code. Type a slash followed by T1, identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Type another slash, then letter B to identify the fare base. Enter the issued ticket fare base. Press Enter. This process will update the fare base for all lines of the TST. To update the not valid before and not valid after dates in the TST record, follow these steps. Use the TTK transaction code. Type a slash followed by T1, identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Type another slash, then letter V, identify the validity. Enter the dates in the format 19 July for the not valid before date and 16 Jan for the not valid after date. Press Enter. This will update the not valid before and not valid after dates for all lines of the TST. To update the baggage allowances in the TST record, follow these steps. Use the TTK transaction code. Type a slash followed by T1, identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Type another slash, then letter, identify baggage allowances. Enter 2PC as the required baggage allowances. Press Enter. This will update the baggage allowances in the TST record as specified. To update the origin and destination in the TST record, follow these steps. Use the TTK transaction code. Type A/ followed by T1. Identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Type another slash, then letter D to identify origin and destination. Enter KHI 3 letters code for the origin city, Karachi. Enter KHI 3 letters code for the origin city, final destination city. Press enter. This will update the origin and destination in the TST record as required. To initiate the reissue process, follow these steps. Use the TTK transaction code with the slash EXEH to start the reissue process. Type A/ followed by T1. Identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Press enter. System automated. The letter F, first issue fare indicator, will change to R, reissue. The letter X, new tax, will be replaced by letter O, old tax or collected, and the total amount will be set to 0 by default. The equivalent amount has been removed when dealing with dual currencies. It is recommended to manually update the equivalent amount and old banking selling rate, BSR, to ensure accuracy. To update the TST record with the equivalent amount and banking selling rate, follow these steps. Use the TTK transaction code. Type A/ followed by T1. Identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Type another slash, then letter E. Identify the equivalent amount. Enter PKR Pakistani Rupees, currency 3 letter code, followed by the amount. Type another slash, then K1. Identify the banking selling rate. Enter the amount without spaces. Press enter. This will update the TST with the required equivalent amount and banking selling rate. To update the fare calculation with the involuntary reissue indicator in the TST record, follow these steps. Use the TTK transaction code. Type A/ followed by T1. Identify the transitional stored ticket with the number 1. Type another slash, then letter C. Identify fare calculation. Enter letter I to set the involuntary reissue indicator, followed by a dash. Press enter. This will update the fare calculation line in the TST for the involuntary reissue. To update the endorsement FE field with a waiver code or remarks along with the previous remarks, follow these steps. Locate the FE endorsement element. Enter the number 13 followed by a slash. Add the old remarks followed by another slash. Enter the new waiver code or remarks as per airline procedures or advised. Press enter. This will update the FE endorsement element in the PNR with the new waiver code or remarks while retaining the previous remarks. Alternatively, you can cancel the existing F element from the PNR and re-enter it with both the old remarks and the new waiver code or remarks. To update the FO original issue ticket details for a reissue, follow these steps. First, display the issued ticket details. Use the TWD transaction. Type a slash, followed by the letter L. Identify the line. Enter number 11. Specify the FA element from the PNR. Press enter. To pull the issued e-ticket details, use the FO transaction. Identify the original issued ticket in exchange. Type an asterisk, followed by the letter L. Identify the line. Then number 11 for the FA element from the PNR. Press enter. To update display details on the screen, place the cursor next to number 17 at the end of the FO displayed line. Type A/, then P1. Identify passenger number 1. Type another slash followed by letter S. Identify the segment. Enter number 4. Dash. 6. Specify the required segments from line number 4 to line number 6 in the PNR. Press enter. The FO original issued e-ticket data will be updated on line 15 in the PNR. Save the changes to ensure the updated information is stored. The PNR will be redisplayed on your screen for further action. To issue a new ticket and ensure accuracy, follow these steps. First, display the last issued ticket. Use the TWD transaction. Type a slash, followed by the letter L. Identify the line. Enter number 11. Specify the FA element from the PNR. Press enter. This process ensures the correct issuance of the new ticket while avoiding duplicates or errors. To issue the new ticket, use the TTP transaction code. Type a slash followed by P, 1 identify passenger number 1. Type another slash, then letter S, identify the segment. Enter number 4. Dash 6, specify the required segments of the new itinerary from line number 4 to line number 6 in the PNR. Press enter. The system will respond with OK e-ticket, indicating that the new ticket has been successfully issued. To retrieve and display the new e-ticket record in the PNR, follow these steps. Ensure the PNR is displayed on your screen. To display the new issued e-ticket record, use the TWD transaction. Type a slash followed by the letter L, identify the line. Enter number 13. Specify the F, a element from the PNR. Press enter. This will display the details of the newly issued e-ticket record updated in the PNR displayed. To display the original issued ticket details after an involuntary reissue, use the TWD transaction. Type a slash, followed by the letter O to identify the original issued, followed by an asterisk sign. Then press enter. For reissued itineraries, the coupon status is E to identify exchange. Additionally, the letter I indicates an involuntary reissue. That's it. You have learned how to manually handling involuntary reissues. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative videos.